I have no idea what attracts me to review these mediocre to bad rhythm games. Games like Britney's Dance Beat, Rock Revolution, and so forth. Nothing really have anything redeeming and they can be finished in 5 hours or less. So which one do I have this time? It's American Idol, and not the PS2 rhythm game or Karaoke Revolution Presents American Idol. It's the GBA port of the PS2 game. The development is pretty self-explanatory for a GBA port of a cash-in game. It was developed by Mobius Entertainment, published by Codemasters, and released in November 2003. To cut it short and sweet, Mobius Entertainment is a 3-person development team founded in 1997. They've developed mostly games for the handheld market. Some of them include games like Army Men Turf War, Drone Racers, the GBA version of Max Payne, and the GBA ports of High Heat Baseball 2002 through 2004. The only other interesting thing I found out about them was that this is the team that would eventually turn into Rockstar Leeds in 2004. And the rest is history on them. The story of the game is pretty much what happens on the American Idol TV show. You go through the tryouts and the whole elimination process to eventually become the winner of American Idol. Need I say more? The graphics are okay. From a screenshot's perspective, it's not as good looking as Britney's Dance Beat. The thing is that from art and how it runs perspective, it's a much better looking game. While Britney's Dance Beat looks more robotic and faker than a Barbie doll, American Idol has a lot more life to the graphics. It's colorful, it emulates the PS2 game's art to the best that GBA can do, and has a lot more life to the art than a Britney's Dance Beat ever had. There are two issues I have with the game's graphics. First problem I have is that game developers really need to learn just because you might be able to do so doesn't mean you should. The game's frame rate is okay, but not as good when you compare it to a good console rhythm game. I'll get into that later why this is a big deal, more so to me. Yes, it runs better than Britney's Dance Beat for the same console, but like I said, just because you can doesn't mean that you should. My only other issue is that there's a lot of pixelation. The 3D models have a lot of jagged lines, and in general, it's not the most pleasant game to look at when you play it outside of a GBA. It's not that big of a deal, but it's very noticeable. So overall, it's not the best looking game, but for 2003, it's pretty decent. The audio is bad. Again, much like Britney's Dance Beat, this is another case of I really don't care for the music. With that said, it also suffers from a lot of the same problems as Britney's Dance Beat. The game has a fair bit of variety as far as music. You got pop music ranging from boy bands like Backstreet Boys and NSYNC, female songwriters like Madonna and Christina Aguilera, along with foreign attractions such as Ricky Martin. Where it goes wrong is not only that they couldn't get the rights to songs and only the lyrics, but the singers that are supposed to be a representation of those who make it to the American Idol show are awful. No matter how good you are doing, unless you are hitting every note perfectly, then the singers always sound like they're having voice cracks on a regular basis. This compounds the fact that, much like the console version, they don't use the entire song. Yes, the GBA has a limited amount of room, but if you can't give me the entire song, then give me something that is more than what would happen if I sang the songs myself. The gameplay is okay at best. Again, much like Britney's Dance Beat, for its time it was a nice distraction, but it's virtually obsolete when you compare it to games like Karaoke Revolution. The gameplay is much like Britney's Dance Beat. You got a circle with different buttons to end the time to the music. There's still the standard modes like Practice Survival, so it's pretty by the books as far as modes and gameplay is concerned. Here's where it gets it right compared to Britney's Dance Beat. The hit detection is much better. You can work out timing for each note, so immediately this is miles ahead of Britney's Dance Beat. Where it gets it wrong is that there are two annoyances that will come into play. The first is the useless customization. I know the fact that customization was limited for GBA, and it's very nice to see in any game for the Game Boy Advance at all. Where I find it annoying is that the game plays it up like your appearance means something that really never does. You could look like a big pile of garbage, and if you hit every note, it really doesn't matter, making the style system completely worthless. The other big annoyance is that this game has a big time deadweight password system. When I think of passwords, I think of all the games that sent me back to the last level I died at, in which they gave me a password for. This game flips the scenario on you. What the password system does is it unlocks all the items you got from beating the song. So if you fail a song, you got to play them all again. Sure, you can play the songs you didn't select in the first, second, and third rounds, but when the singer sounds like a constant voice crack, what's the point? These elements make this game a good GBA cash-in rhythm game, but not a good GBA game in general. Overall, American Idol is passable at best, and on any other day, it's a nuisance. This was on the PSP, Rock Band Unplugged would laugh its butt off. There is one thing that gives it some redeeming value. That is when the competition is Britney's Dance Beat and I think a Bratz game for best rhythm game on the GBA, it's not the worst pick in the world. If you have a GBA and you need a rhythm game, then American Idol is an okay idea. Outside of that, or being a big American Idol fan that needs everything related to the show, then don't bother. There are too many better options out there. I give it a 5 out of 10.